Welcome to Grab & Go Info. Databricks supports Git integration. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to do GitHub repo operation on the Databricks platform. You will learn how to enable files other than notebooks in the Databricks repo, how to create a branch on Databricks, how to create a notebook in Databricks repo, how to push updates to a remote repository, how to create and merge a pull request, how to pull remote repository changes into Databricks. Let's get started. Databricks repos only sync notebooks with a remote Git repository by default. To allow other file formats such as PI, CSV, and MD in the repo, we need to change the repo's settings in the admin console. Step 0.1, open the admin console by clicking Settings. Then Admin Console. Step 0.2. Click Workspace Settings on the menu. Step 0.3. Go to the Repos section and enable Files and Repos. After it is enabled, we can sync any file type with the remote Git repository. We can also view and edit text files in the UI. In the first step, we will create a branch on Databricks. Step 1.1. Click Repos. Then the username and main. Step 1.2. Type a branch name and press the Enter key to create the branch. Step 1.3. To switch between branches, click the downward arrow and select the branch name. We selected the test branch here. Click the Close button to close the window. In the second step, we will create a new notebook in the test branch. There are three ways to create a new notebook in the repo: creating a notebook from scratch, importing an existing notebook, or cloning a notebook from Workspace. Step 2.1. To create a notebook from scratch, go to Repos, Username, click the downward arrow near the branch name. Select Create, then Notebook. Step 2.2. To import an existing notebook, go to Repos, Username, click the downward arrow near the branch name, then select Import. We can either import a file or import from a URL. Step 2.3. To clone a notebook from the workspace, go to Workspace, then Username. Click the downward arrow next to the notebook name and select Clone. A new window will pop up. Give the clone notebook a new name. Then select Repos, Username, and the repo name. Click the blue Clone button to clone the notebook. Step 2.4. To check if the notebook has been created, go to Repos, Username, then click the repo name. We can see that notebook has been successfully cloned to the branch. If you found the information helpful so far, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. In the third step, we will push updates to the remote repository. Step 3.1, click the branch name to open the repo window. We can see that the newly added example notebook is shown as the changed file. Provide a summary and click the blue commit and push button. Step 4.1, go to the GitHub repo that is connected to Databricks, and you will see a message about the push. Click the green compare and pull request button to open a pull request. Step 4.2. On the open a pull request page, click the green create pull request button to create a pull request. Step 4.3. After the pull request is approved, click the green merge pull request button. Then click the green confirm merge button. Step 4.4. After the merge is confirmed, we will see a purple merge button showing that the pull request is successfully merged and closed. We can click the Delete Branch button to delete the branch. Step 4.5. Click the repository name, and we can see the notebook show up in the repository. Step 4.6. Go to Databricks and switch to the main branch. We can see the newly added notebook now show up in the main branch. In Step 5, let's make some changes to the README file on GitHub and pull the changes into Databricks. Step 5.1. Go to the GitHub repository for Databricks and click the pencil icon for the README file. Step 5.2. I added the sentence "This is a new sentence added in GitHub" and click the green commit changes button. Step 5.3. Go back to Databricks and click Repos, Username, then Main. In the pop-up window, click Pull. Step 5.4. A warning window pops up and asks if we want to proceed with pulling. Click the blue confirm button to start pulling the changes. Step 5.5. After finishing pulling the changes, close the repo window, then click the README file. we can see that the new sentence we added on GitHub are pulled into Databricks. In this tutorial, we talked about how to do GitHub repo operation on the Databricks platform. You learned how to enable files other than notebooks in the Databricks repo, how to create a branch on Databricks, how to create a notebook in Databricks repo, how to push updates to a remote repository, how to create and merge a pull request, how to pull remote repository changes into Databricks. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and big data processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in the video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.